Visual activities are the quickest way to turn qualitative feedback into actionable insights. In this video, you'll learn how to choose the right activities to match your intent, how to customize and share those activities to drive participation, and how to synthesize results from those activities to help you move forward with purpose. Let's take a look at this first one. When you click the visual activities icon in Lucidchart or Lucidspark, you open the gallery. Here you'll be able to view all sorts of activities, but with so many options to choose from, it can be difficult to know which one is the right one. So let me share a secret that can help you to simplify this process. All visual activities can be broken down into three main categories. First, you have the visual activities that are designed to help you strengthen connections with others. You can typically find them in the team building section, and they look like icebreakers or get to know yous. You'll want to use them anytime you need to bring energy and camaraderie to your meetings. Second, you have the visual activities that provide insights into the needs and expectations of others. These are typically found in the gallery under the customer research or one-to-one sections and tend to have questions as titles or systems for ranking objects. You'll want to use these visual activities anytime you need to understand how others are thinking or feeling about a particular topic. And finally, you have visual activities that help you build consensus and take action with others. Most of these activities can be found in the gallery under the meetings and workshops or project planning sections, and have objects that can be sorted into different themed boxes. You'll want to use these activities anytime you need to prioritize work throughout the duration of a project's lifecycle. By recognizing the intent of these activities, you can rest assured that the visual activity you choose is the right one every time. Just grab the thumbnail of the visual activity you'd like to use and place it on the canvas. Now I'm going to show you how to customize and share your visual activity. You can begin customizing your visual activity as soon as it's placed on the canvas. You'll be able to change things like title, instructions, and labels. But this is also where you can add any interactive objects. I'm going to explain each of these items and show you how to customize your own, starting with title. A clear title can attract participants and provide visibility into what they'll be doing. It's best to identify the theme or purpose of your activity and then title it accordingly. Click once on the title to input your change, type out your text, and then press apply. Your new title should now be visible in the top left corner of your activity. Next are instructions. Well-written instructions allow others to participate in the activity instead of wondering whether they're doing it right. Make your objectives clear and use words that make them easy to follow. Click once to edit the text box, type in your change, and then click outside the text box to make your revisions stay. You can also customize labels in the same way. Access labels provide contextual information for participants interacting with an activity. In most cases, these will already be completed for you. But if you ever need to make a change, follow the same steps that were provided for instructions. And finally, there's interactive objects. Interactive objects are items participants can move to share their opinions or provide deeper insights. Some of our templates have designated areas to drop shapes and automatically make them interactive. But nearly any object can become interactive by clicking on the hand icon. A green hand icon indicates that the object is draggable. This means participants will be able to interact with it during the visual activity. Use this for items you want to move, like sticky notes, GIFs, Lucid cards, and more. If you click the green hand icon, you'll notice that it changes to a gray hand icon with a line going through it. This makes the object static, or in other words, it makes it so participants will not be able to interact with it during the visual activity. Use this setting for items you don't want to move, like your instructions and your access labels. Remember, green means go, gray means no, or something like that. You can also remove any confusion and increase participation by clearly indicating which items are interactive and which ones are not. Leverage designated areas by placing interactive objects inside of them to help keep things simple. Before exiting editing, it's best to preview your activity. This way you can try everything out and make sure it works before inviting others. Just click the preview button, read through your instructions, and then try moving your objects. If everything looks good, Click here to return to editing and then click Save Changes. Now you're ready to share your visual activity with others. Click the Share button, determine your sharing permissions, and then copy the direct link to your computer clipboard. Paste the URL to share your visual activity with others. When a participant clicks the link, they'll be taken directly to your visual activity. And if you're facilitating a live session and have a team or enterprise account, you can bring everyone to your visual activity by navigating to the More menu and clicking Start Activity for Everyone. And if you go back one more time, you'll also have the ability to make participants anonymous by clicking the toggle here. Once everyone's been able to participate in your visual activity, you're ready to move on to the final step, which is to synthesize results so you can move forward with purpose. Depending on the visual activity you selected, you may see one of two results. I'm going to show an example of each of these so that you'll be able to synthesize results from either one. To see your participants' responses, click View Results in the visual activity. If the activity consisted of a slider, axis, or matrix, your results will look something like this. At first glance, you'll be able to see the average results across participants. This is great for gaining consensus and leveraging those results to unify insights. However, you'll also be able to view an individual's results by clicking on the participant's name. If you notice that participant results are overlapping and it's difficult to see where objects were plotted, just click Resolve Overlap to separate the objects for easier viewing. Or click this button to see everything in the dot view. You can also click on an object to the right to view participant results for that specific item. Now, if your visual activity consisted of a categorization activity where items were placed into boxes, your results will look a little bit different. On the left, you'll have two tabs. One is the Overview tab, which visualizes items by the highest amount of agreement, and the other is Objects View, which provides a breakdown of how each object was categorized. Just like with the prioritization results, you'll still be able to select participants or click on objects for additional information. And in the top right, you can adjust the number of responses needed to finalize agreement by adjusting the agreement threshold here. If you're planning on sharing these results with others, or just want to add them to the board so you don't have to jump into the visual activity each time, you can. Just click this button, and whatever results you're currently looking at in the visual activity will then be added to the board. But simply looking at results isn't enough to affect change. You'll also need to use these results to move forward with purpose. I'm going to show you an example of what this may look like. Let's say I wanted to check my team's energy level after completing a busy sprint. I'd select this energy level activity, customize it to my team, and then share the activity with them. Within seconds, I'll have the data that I need to help me make decisions around each team member's capacity for our upcoming sprint. For example, I can see that Morgan's energy level is high while Tori's energy is low. I may want to reach out to Tori and see how I can support her to help her with her energy levels for this upcoming sprint. Or maybe I'll just use this information to lower Tori's capacity for the next sprint in order to help her recuperate. Either way, because I leveraged the visual activity, I was able to collect the information that I needed to help my team move forward energized for their next sprint. And now that you know how to choose the right activity to match your intent, customize and share those activities to drive participation, and then synthesize results from those activities to move forward with purpose, you're ready to make better decisions faster than ever before. But this is only the beginning. To learn even more ways Lucid can improve your team's workflows, visit us at Lucid Training Labs.